Good morning to you, my brothers and sisters. My family in Christ, I trust that this morning finds you blessed and highly favored, and that you have woken up to a beautiful day. Let us pray together. Thank you, Father, for a day blessed by you. Thank you for your mercies and your watchfulness over us while we slept last night. And thank you for the grace and the mercy that you bestow upon us every day. I pray that you bless the word this morning, and that every good thing will come from it, and that we are reminded that in all things, you are our provider. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, this morning our scripture reading is taken from the first book of Chronicles, chapter 16, verses 34. Give thanks to the Lord because he is good. His love is eternal. This is the word of the Lord. When the Christian comes before the Lord, much time is spent on intercession. Requests on behalf of the one who is praying and on behalf of others are often brought to the foot of God's throne of grace. Worries and fears and anxieties are brought to God while seeking his assistance and guidance. And indeed, many people's prayers to God consist of personal requests only. We must, however, never make the mistake of neglecting to praise and to thank the Lord in our prayer life. Remember all the love that he has shown us in our lives, and take note of the blessings which he lavishes upon us. We need to get ourselves to a place where we remember all the instances and times when Jesus helped us to overcome obstacles, and also how he provided in our lives and in our everyday needs. These blessings should never be belittled simply because they are common and we survive and live through them every day. We should not also never for a moment think that God doesn't need our praise and our thanksgiving. And so by faithfully doing this, we find that in our spirit we are constantly drawn closer to the risen Savior. Our worship, our praise and gratitude should not only be lip service, but should flow sincerely from our hearts. While we are praising God's holy name and thanking him, we will find ourselves being surrounded more and more by his love, to the extent that later on we will find and experience that the unity with the living Christ, which is the deep desire of every true disciple of the Master, comes to pass. Gratitude is the trademark of a Christian. Therefore, in, through, and by all things, be thankful to God. So this morning, my brothers and sisters, let us praise, worship, give thanks always. For our God is good and worthy of all thanksgiving. Today, name and list the things that you are thankful for, and bless the Lord for all he has done. Give thanks and remain under the eternal grace and love of God. I encourage you to read Psalm 103 and see the faithfulness of God. May you have a blessed day, and may you share your gratitude and make it known to God. Amen.
for all the things that you've done for me. Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love to me. And the voices of a million angels did not express my gratitude. That I am and ever hope to be.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the word today. And thank you for reminding us that all that we are and all that we ever hope to be and all that we have are gifts from your hand. And that we should be in a spirit of thanksgiving at all times. For your mercies are new every morning and your grace is sufficient for every need. Thank you. Thank you. For your love that is eternal. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.